सो क्वेश्चन नंबर 13, सो हाउ मेनी थ्री डिजिट नंबर आर डिविजिबल बाय 7. सो क्वेश्चन नंबर सेज हाउ मेनी थ्री डिजिट नंबर आर डिविजिबल बाय 7. सो फर्स्ट, व्हाट इज द फर्स्ट थ्री डिजिट नंबर? व्हाट इज द फर्स्ट थ्री डिजिट नंबर
व्हिच इज डिविजिबल बाय 7?
नो नो, नॉट एज लाइक डिविजिबल बाय. फर्स्ट थ्री डिजिट नंबर इज, व्हाट इज फर्स्ट थ्री डिजिट नंबर इन मैथमेटिक्स?
100.
सो 100 इज द फर्स्ट थ्री डिजिट नंबर. व्हेदर इट इज डिविजिबल बाय, whether it is divisible by 7, we'll check it. 7 ones are 7, 3, 0, 30, 4 za, how much?
38.
So how much remaining? 2. So 2, if I add 5 to this, what I get? 7, right?
7, yeah.
So that means I have to add 5 to which number then?
100.
100. So five numbers I have to add it. So the first number, therefore, first number divisible by 7 is
105.
The next number divisible by 7 is 112.
Hmm.
So therefore, AP will be, or therefore, AP will be 105, 112, 119, and so on, right? Last number, which is the last three digit number, 999.
Mm.
So I'll divide with 7. Okay. 7 ones are 7. Okay. 2, 9, 4 za. How much? 28. 1, 9 carry. So 2 za. 14. How much remaining?
14.
How much 5. Remaining? How much remaining? 5. That means if I subtract 5 from this, I can't add 5 to this because it becomes 4 digit number. So what I have to do?
Hmm.
I have to
subtract
5. 5 from 9999. If I subtract 5 from 999, I get 994.
90. Yeah.
So this becomes the last number.
Hmm.
So yeah. I know from this A is given 105 and D is 7 because it is multiplicable by 7 only. The difference also will be 7. Okay. Understood now how we got 7?
Yes, sir.
So, and the last number, AN, they have given how much? 994. I have to find what? How many terms? Three digit number. So, I have to find what? N?
N.
N. So, we know AN, they have given AN is equal to 994. AN formula, A plus N minus 1 into D is equal to 994. A, I know, 105. Plus N, I don't know. D, I know, 7. 994. I send 105 to the other side. N minus 1 into 7 will be equal to 994 minus 105. So it is 994 minus 105. So this becomes 8, 14, 14, 14 minus 5, 9, 8 minus 0, 8, 9 minus 1 is 8. How much I get?
889.
So 7 is equal to 889. Then N minus 1 is equal to 889 divided by 7. Right? 7 ones are 7 ones are 7.
Yeah.
So you get one more here, 18. 7 twos are 14. 4 remaining. 7 sevens are 120. Sorry, 49. Understood?
Hmm.
Understood division, Samruddhi?
Yes, yes.
So N minus 1 is equal to 127. Then therefore, N will be how much? 127 plus 1, then when will be?
128.
So therefore, how many three digit number are there? 128. Three digit numbers are divisible by 7. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Copy down. Next question is question number 14. What is question number 14? How many multiples of 4 lie between 10 and 250? How many multiples of 4 lie between 10 to 250? So between they have given. So that means you are not supposed to take 10 and
250.
Okay. So first number I know. Okay. So multiple of 215 means first number is 4. Because if I multiply 4 3 times, I get 12.
Hmm.
Next 16. Next 24. So on, right?
Hmm.
I'll check 250 if it is divisible by 4 or not. 4 6 are 24. 1 0. 2 are 8. 2 remaining. So I have to subtract 2.
Yeah.
Because between, no? So then last number is 248. Understood now how to find AP?
Yes, sir.
Samruddhi?
Yes.
So what you have to find here?
N.
Previous problem only. Same as previous problem. A they have given. How much? Well, B, 16 minus 12 is 4 only because four. Multiple of 4. Then AN?
248.
Then we know AN formula, A plus N minus 1 into D, which is equal to 248. A I know, 12, plus N I don't know, D I know 4 is equal to 248. Then sending 12 other side, I'm subtracting 248 minus 12, N minus 1 into 4 is equal to 236. 236, right?
Yes, sir.
10, 38, 2 minus 36. So N minus 1 is equal to 236 divisible by 4. 4 5s are 20, 3 remaining. 9s are? 9s are much? 36 are? 36 yeah. Remaining, right? Correct, huh? 60 times is not 4, 0, you have to get 0, no? One second. You made some mistake. Where I made mistake? 23, 3 carry, 36, correct only. 60, but... Okay, fine. So there are 60 terms. 60 terms means 40 times, 4, 3 times means 460 is not 38, right? Once again, any mistake you have done here? 4, 240, A plus N minus 1 into D, 240, 8, the same 12 other side minus 12 in 38, 38, 36, correct. Correct only. N minus 1 is 59. Then N will be how much? N will be how much? 58. 60, no?
Oh, sorry, 60.
Plus 1. Then N will be equivalent to 60. So how many terms are there?
60 terms.
60 terms out there. Okay, fine. Copy down. Question number 15. Question number 15 says, for what value of nth term? For value of nth term? For what value of n are the nth term of two APs? They have given two APs. So first AP is AP1. First AP is 63, 65, 69 and dash dash dash. I have how many terms? N terms I have. Similarly, I have another AP, AP2. So AP2 is 3, 10, 17, dash dash dash. We have N terms. And they are saying that for what value of N? The nth terms are equal. That means they have given that an of first AP is equivalent to an of second AP. Right?
Mm.
So I have to find what?
An.
N, not an. N. I have to find n. Right? What is the formula for an1? It is a1 plus n minus 1 into d1.
Hmm.
Understood. N is same only. For both, N is same. A2 plus N minus 1 into D2.
Yeah.
What is A1? 63. D1 is 65 minus 63. That is D1 will become?
2.
Similarly, what is A2? 3. 3. And D2? 10 minus 3.
10 minus
D2 7. Is 7. Substitute the values. Substituting A1, D1, A2 and D2. A1 is 63 plus N minus 1. D1 is 2 is equal to A2, 3 plus N I don't know. D I know. D2 I know. How much?
7.
So, 63 plus 2N minus 2 na. I'm multiplying 2 inside. And 3 plus 7N minus 7 na. I'm multiplying 7 inside. Understood?
Yes, sir.
So, 63 minus 2 is 61 plus 2N is equal to 7N. 3 minus 7 is 4. Understood?
Yeah.
So, I'm sending 7N to the other side and I'm bringing 61 to the RHS. Then 2N minus 7N I get plus 7N. If it first 7N goes the other side, you get minus 2N, right?
Yeah.
61, if it comes to the RHS side, it becomes minus 61. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Minus 5N because it is 7N minus 2N. Different sign, subtract. 5N. Bigger number is minus, so minus. Then I get same sign. I have to add 65. Then what is N equal to then? N is equal to minus 65 divided by minus 5.
Yeah.
5 ones are 5. 13s are 60. So therefore, what is N?
13.
So therefore, 13th term of 2 APs will be equal. Understood? Understood? Yep. Samruddhi?
Yes.
Okay, copy down. Question number 16. Determine the AP whose third term is 16 and the seventh term exceeds the fifth term by 12. So I have to find AP. They have asked you to find AP. So what is the general form of AP? What's the general form of AP?
A plus D.
A plus D. A plus 2D.
A plus 2D.
A plus
3D.
3D and so on, right? A plus 3D yeah. And so on. Okay.
Yep.
Now they have given that third term is 16. That is A3 is 16. And they are saying that seventh term exceeds fifth term. So it is more than fifth term by how much?
17.
12.
Oh, sorry.
12. Seventh term exceeds the fifth term by 12. Understood? Understood?
Yes, sir. Yeah.
So to find AP, I have to find out A first and D. Am I right? If I know A and D, I can find AP. So using the equations, A3 can be written as A plus 2D is equal to 16 and A plus 6D is equal to A plus 4D plus 12. Which formula I have used?
AN
formula. AN formula. A plus N minus 1 into D. Understood, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
So, solving equation 2. From equation 2, I can find. So, solving equation 2, I get A minus A plus 6D minus 4D is equal to 12. I'm shifting everything to the other side. A becomes minus A, 4D becomes minus D, right?
Yes, sir.
Plus A and minus A get cancelled. Yeah, tell me.
Nothing.
Okay, fine. Then 6 minus 4D is 2D. 12. 2 ones are 2. How much is that?
6.
Then what is D equal to?
6.
6. Then therefore, substitute D is equal to 6 in equation 1. And if equation 1, if I substitute 2D is equal to 16, then A plus 2 into 6 is equal to 16. A plus 12 is equal to 16. A is equal to 16 minus 12. A will be how much? 16 minus 12.
4.
So what is A value?
4.
4. A value is 4. Then what is AP? AP. AP is first term is 4. For that, how much I have to add?
6.
D I have to add? 4 plus 2 into 6 plus 4 plus 2, 3 into 6, right? Then what I get? 4, 10,
10
16. 16, then 22,
22,
and so on. Therefore, AP is what? What is AP?
4, 10, 16, and 22.
22 and dash dash dash. Understood?
Yeah.
Understood?
Yeah.
Okay, fine. Copy down. Question number 17. Question number 17. Find the 20th term from the last. So I have to find what? 20th term from where?
The last.
From last. Of AP, they have given AP 3, 8, 13, --253. From the last, I have to write, then AP becomes what? Therefore, AP I can write like 253. Right? Here, if I found if I find common difference between this, that is there is plus 5, right?
Yeah.
Then if I have to find the common difference, then I have to subtract it, the previous term. Then if I subtract 5, what I get? 248.
Yeah.
Dash dash dash. So on up to where I have number 3. They have been given. What is A from this number? From this AP?
253.
D? 248 5. Minus 253. That will be equal to minus 5.
Minus 5.
So I have to find out A20. A20 can be written as A plus 19D. Formula. A plus 9 minus 1 into D. Then A I know how much?
253.
Plus 19 into minus 5. What is 19 5 za? 19 5 is 95.
Yeah.
253 minus 95. 4, 13. How much? 8. 24 minus 9. 15. What is the value?
158.
So what is 20th term from the last?
158.
Therefore, 20th term from last of given AP is 158. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Okay, fine. Copy down. Copy down, copy down fast. It's about to rain. I don't know when power will go. Okay, there might be a power. Question number 18. The sum of 4th and 8th term of AP is 24. So they have given sum, right? Sum means what? Addition.
Adding.
So what I have to add? 4th term and 8th term is equal to how much? 24 they have given. Let it be equation 1. And sum of 6th and 10th term. Sum of 6th plus 10th term. How much?
44.
10, oh sorry, 44. Okay, 44. So, and I have to find first three terms of AP. So find first three terms of AP. Then I have to find out A1, A2 and A3. A1 is nothing but A, A2 is A plus D, and A3 is A2 plus D, right? So I have to find this three, question mark. So given 1 and 2, I'll write in an equation form using formula An is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. Done? Then I get first equation, A plus 3D plus A plus 7D is equal to 24. Correct?
Yeah.
Fourth term can be written as A plus 3D and eighth term can be written as A plus 7D. And sixth term can be written as A plus 5D plus A plus 90 is equal to 44. Done? Then this implies 2A plus 10D is equal to 24 and 2A plus 14D is equal to 44. Right?
Yeah.
Changing sign and solving. On solving. Okay, let it be equation 3. And equation 4. On solving equation 3 and 4, I get 2a cancel. Minus 4d is equal to minus 20.
Yeah.
Minus and minus cancel. 4 ones are 4, 5s are. Then what is d equal to?
5.
Then what I do is I substitute. Substitute d is equal to 5 in equation 3. Equation 3, what is equation 3? 2a plus 5d is equal to 24. Then 2a plus 5 into 5a.
Yeah.
Is equal to 24. How much I get? 2a is equal to
10D,
it's 10D. Okay. 10D. Tell me. So 10 into 5. 2A plus 50 is equal to 24. 2A is equal to 24 minus 50. Then 2A will be how much? Minus 26.
Yeah.
2 ones are 2, 13s are. Then what is A equal to?
13.
Minus 13.
Minus 13.
Therefore, first three terms of AP are, first term is A, how much? Minus 13. Second term is A plus D, that is minus 13 plus 5, which is equal to minus 8.
Yeah.
Then A3 is equal to A2 plus D. A2 is minus 8 plus 5. How much? Minus 3. Minus 3, right?
Yeah.
So what is the value then? Therefore, A1 is equal to minus 13. A2 is equal to minus 8. And A3 is equal to how much?
Minus 3.
Understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Copy down. I'll do question number 19 and question number 20 is same as 19. You have to try. Fine.
Yeah, sir.
Okay. Question number 19 I'll do. Question number 20, take it as homework and do. If you don't understand, we'll just do it in tomorrow's class. Fine.
Yes, sir.
Subba Rao started working in 2095. That means 1995. In 1995, he started working and his annual salary is rupees 5,000. That means that is his first year working. So that means A1 will be how much?
5,000.
He received an increment of 200 every year. That means in second year, he got 200 more. That means D is how much then?
200.
That means his income in second year will become 5,200. Fine?
Yeah.
In which year is income will be or salary will be income will be or salary will be ₹7,000. ₹7,000. Understood?
7,000.
So I have to find out what?
N.
So we know AN, they have given AN. The last, let me take that. Nth year is income is 7,000. That means AN is 7,000. Understood?
Yeah.
So A plus N minus 1 into D is how much?
7,000.
Then what is A? 5,000.
5,000.
N minus 1 into D. D how much?
200.
D how much? 200.
Yeah.
Send N minus 1 into 200 is equal to 7,000 minus 5,000. Understood?
Yes, sir.
N minus 1 is equal to 7,000 minus 500 is 2,000 divided by 200. Multiplication is there. Two zeros cancel. N ones are, N tens, two ones are, two tens are. So N minus 1 is equal to 10. N is equal to how much?
11.
After 11 years, his income will be?
7,000.
So that means 11 years means I have to add 1995 plus 11 years. So that will be equivalent to 2006, right? 10 yeah. years means 2005, 1 year more, 2006. So therefore, in 2006, his income will be how much?
7,000.
Will be how much? ₹7,000. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Samruddhi, understood?
Yes.
Okay, fine.